Okay, in the Cauchy's theorem, we will see the next example. Verify Cauchy's theorem for the function f of z equals to z square, where z is a square having the vertices 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1 and 0. Means here they have given us, they are telling curl is nothing but the square and f of z is z square. Here they are telling verify Cauchy's theorem for the given function z square. Verifying Cauchy's theorem means nothing but showing that integration of f of z equals to 0. And our f of z is nothing but z square. Okay. Here c is a square OA BC. And we have by Cauchy's theorem integration of f of z equals to f of z dz equals to 0. Means we need to show that. Okay, that means we need to show that integration means now we will split that function with the four parts along OA, along AB, along BC and along CO. We will split that function, that is the integration of z square dz along OA plus integration of z square dz along AB, integration of z square dz along BC plus integration of z square dz along CO. We will show this equals to 0. Okay, next we will go by one along the paths. First along the path OA. Along the path OA we can show that here y is equals to, we can see here y is equals to 0. Okay, differentiate that one, we will get dy equals to 0. That is x lying between 0 to 1. 0 less than equals to x less than equals to 1. Consider the function z square dz, that is x plus iy. We know that z is nothing but x plus iy. X plus iy whole square into dx plus I dy equals 2. Here we know that y is 0. Therefore this becomes what? X square, and dy is also 0. Therefore it is x square dx. Now we will go for that integration. Integration z square dz along OA, that is nothing but x square dx, where the limits are x equals to 0 to 1. Integration of x square is x cube by 3. 0 to 1. Substitute the limits. It is 1 by 3. Let us take it as equation 1. Next, along path AB. Along path AB, here x equals to 1. You can see here x equals to 1. Dx equals to 0. Differentiation of x is dx equals to 0. You can observe that y is lying between 0 to 1. 0 less than equals to y, less than equals to 1. Consider the function z square dz. X plus iy whole square dx plus I dy. Okay, here we have x equals to 1, that is 1 plus iy whole square into dx is 0. Therefore, it is I dy. Okay. Next, consider the integration of that function. Integration of z square dz along ab, that is I into 1 plus iy whole square dy. Y equals to 0 to 1. Next exponent, that is by using a plus b whole square, we get 1 plus I square y square. We know that I square is minus 1, that's why I have written directly, that is minus y square plus 2iy into dy. Next, integrate this one. Integration of 1 is y. Integration of y square is y cube by 3. Integration of y is y square by 2. And here 2 will get cancelled. Substitute the limits and simplify. Here we are getting 2 by 3i plus I square, and we know that I square is value is minus 1. Therefore minus 1 plus 2 by 3 into I. Let us take it as equation 2. Next, along path BC. Along path BC, here we can observe that y is equals to 1. Y is equals to 1, then differentiate it, dy equals to 0. Here x is lying between 1 to 0. You can see that it in the arrow mark indicates from here to here meeting. Means what? X is lying between 1 to 0. 1 less than equals to x less than equals to 0. Consider the function z square dz, that is x plus iy whole square into bracket dx plus I dy, that is equals to x plus iy whole square. Means here y is equals to 1. Therefore it is x plus I into 1, that is I, x plus I whole square into dx, because dy is 0. Next, consider the function z square dz, integration of z square dz along the path BC. That is 0 to 1, means we have the values, x values from 1 to 0, x plus I whole square into dx, that is integration expand this x plus I whole square x square plus I square plus 2ix 1 to 0 into dx. Next we know that I square value is minus 1. Next integrate. X square integration is x cube by 3. X minus 1 integration is minus x plus 2i into x integration x square by 2. 2, 2 will get cancels. Next substitute the limits. That is 0 minus. First we are putting 0. That this whole term becomes 0. Next minus we are putting the limit 1. That's why it is minus 1 by 3. Minus into minus plus 1. Next minus I into 1. That is I only. Next simplify this one. We are getting 2 by 3 minus I. Let us take the equation 3. Let's see. Okay, next along the path CO, let us take x equals to 0, differentiation of x is dx equals to 0. Now here you can see that y is lying between 1 and 0, 1 less than equals to y, less than equals to 0. Consider function z square dz, that is x plus i y whole square into dx plus I dy equals to, here x is 0, therefore it is I square y square into dx is 0, I dy. I square is minus 1, therefore it is minus y square into I dy. Consider the function integration of z square into dz along the path CO. That is, minus I is constant here. Take down outside the integration, 1 to 0, y square dy is equals to minus I into integrate y square, that is y cube by 3, 1 to 0, minus I into, okay, upper limit 0, minus lower limit is minus 1 by 3. Minus into minus plus I by 3. Let us take it as equation 4. Next, adding equations 1, 2, 3 and 4, we have, that is LHS part is z square dz along path OA plus integration of z square dz along path AB plus integration of z square dz along path BC plus integration of z square dz along path CO. So, go on substituting. Okay, first equation, from equation 1, it is 1 by 3, from equation 2, it is minus 1 plus 2 by 3 I, next from equation 3, it is 2 by 3 minus I, next from equation 4, it is I by 3. Next, simplify this one. Okay, after simplifying, you can observe that this equals to 0, means integration of I is equals to whatever you have taken, z square dz along the curve C, over C, that is equals to 0. Hence, Cauchy's theorem is verified. Yes, okay.